Well, Elizabeth Tyler, Sharron here at CW39 here in Houston. So excited. Season 2 is going to be coming up tomorrow. So tell us, how are you both feeling? First, we'll start with you, Tyler. How are you feeling about the success of the show? We knew it was going to be successful, but it's putting a smile on a lot of people's faces because of both of you. So how do you feel about it?
You know, it's very humbling, and it's a privilege to be a part of something that means so much to so many people. I think, you know, these characters have been around for a very long time, and there's a reason for that. So we're just very, very much enjoying the ride right now. It's a lot of fun. So I think last season, our showrunner actually had sent me some clips of the pilot airing and people watching the first few minutes of the pilot. And to see, you know, kids who were like 8 years old, or like grown men who were in their 50s, or whoever it might have been, watching the first few minutes, and just kind of that same like joyful reaction to seeing these characters come back to life in a new way. It was really reinvigorating, especially last season being such a long shoot with COVID and everything. So it was nice to see the fans so excited to have these characters back.
Love that. What about you, Elizabeth? How are you feeling about all of this?
Kind of what he said, it's really humbling. Actually, our showrunner, Todd Helbing, had forwarded an email that a fan sent sent to him regarding a scene that I had with Alex Garfin last season, where Lois, it's very emotional, and Lois is trying to give him the strength to pull through, and she's saying, "You're stronger than anyone." And it was a very, very long email that he'd written about how he felt like that scene pulled him out of a dark place and gave him strength. And it was as if his mother had been talking to him. And that was just really moving. And Todd had shared that with me and Alex, just to sort of be like, this is why we do what we do. And that was, it was really wonderful. And we're really excited to share season 2 with the fans.
I know the fans are just chomping at the bit. They're like, come on, let's bring it for sure. But also, I mean, it's a lot of weight on your shoulders, as you both mentioned, being this is iconic characters we're talking about, and a number of different incarnations of people playing these characters. But what is it, start with you this time, Elizabeth, that you have been able to do, do you feel, to make it more of your own, but also staying true to the tradition of who your character is?
Well, you know, all the Loises have a lot in common. They're all very determined. They're all uncompromising. They're very focused on their career. I feel lucky that I get to play an iteration of Lois as a mother, because I, you know, I have a mother myself. My daughter's turning 3 next month. And that just, I mean, the layers of complexity and vulnerability and rawness and everything that that adds makes me feel really grateful. And so in that sense, it's been sort of easy for the two of us to set ourselves a little bit apart, because this, you typically don't see Lois and Clark as parents on screen.
Mm-hmm. And what about you, Tyler?
You know, it's fun. I got comfortable saying this a couple of years ago, but I've never seen any of the Superman's anything. I've seen like an episode or two of the Lois and Clark with Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher from back in the day. But so for me, I've purposely stayed away from it now, because it's just easier for me to go into something with an idea and not be comparing it to what people have or haven't done before. But it's just, I had a great meeting with Greg Berlanti years ago about this character in the first place. And for whatever reason, we just kind of seemed to see him the same way. And so it's been really nice to kind of just to commit to that and kind of take our showrunner, Todd Helbing's lead here with the stories that are coming through for these characters. It's been a lot of fun. And yeah, we hope we get to do it for a while.
Oh, we all do, because it's fun to watch. It really is, especially this version of it. It's a lot of fun. Now, I'm going to take it a little different direction. If there was, and you've probably gotten this question before, Tyler, I'm just going to ask it anyway. If there was one particular characteristic or power, either one, that you could have yourself right now, what would it be? And tell me why.
You know, I've always said it was flying, but after the last few weeks of shoveling snow, I would have taken some heat vision. That would have been a lot easier to get the ice off those stairs. That was quite a bit of time of our holiday break spent shoveling snow. So, I do always say that flight, though. Traveling to me has been my kind of like greatest passion and joy in life that I've found outside of work and family and friends. So, the ability to see the world and meet people from different places, that's just been such an exciting part of life for me the last few years. You know, if I could do that for free without having to book a ticket and deal with change fees and all that, that'd be great.
It'd be wonderful for all of us. And what about you, Elizabeth? Even though you don't have a power as Lois, but Every now and then, if she ever had a chance to have one, would you want a power or one of her characteristics? And tell me why.
Oh, probably just teleportation, kind of for the same reason. Be nice to not have to, you know, sit on a 13-hour flight and just be able to go all over the world. But I like Tyler's answer. Even though shoveling is a good workout.
It was great. It was the whole break.
I tried to have my daughter do it the other day and she was not having it. Like, Mom, I don't want to. And then she just kind of slowly walked and just sat in the snow. I was like, all right.
Wait, not even a snow angel or something? She couldn't even do that?
She was doing snow angels, but I handed her the shovel and I was like, babe, you want to help Mommy? And she's like, not really. Like, all right, I respect that, I guess.
Well, at least you're raising an honest child. How about that? That's a nice way to look. I know our time is short, but I wanted to ask a question. You kind of alluded to this as well. Being that this is a cross-generational type of show that people can see. You can have little ones watching it, people who love the original series or original comics. That is a wonderful and remarkable thing to be able to do, because not every show can do that. So what does that mean to you? Start with you, Elizabeth, being able to have generations, the grandparents, great-grandparents watching it with their grandchildren at the same time and being able to say that.
It's awesome. I mean, it's a family show. And I'm excited. We are starting in an earlier time slot at 8 p.m. now, which is even more conducive to watching together as a family. But I do like that, that everyone can watch together and that there's, you know, there's something appealing for just about every age group. If you want to watch the superhero elements, there's that. If you want to watch the more family, you know, drama, you know, that kind of stuff, there's that for everyone.
Okay. And what about you quickly, Tyler?
Yeah, I just think it's such a privilege to be a part of something that is like that. And that you can even think, I caught a glimpse of the Harry Potter reunion thing the other day. And it was interesting to hear everybody talking about how, like, you know, their kids will then show them these movies. I feel like there's a responsibility that comes with that with shows like this now, because this is such a family show and it's such a generational show. That, you know, if people are watching it down the line, you know, we're really, really excited about the chance to give them something to always come back to and for, you know, future generations to watch and enjoy.
I love it. I know our time's up, so I want to just thank both of you. We can't wait to watch, of course, the start of season two, of course, going to be Tuesday, 7 o'clock Central Time, our time, which is great, and even earlier for all the kids and the family. So great job to both of you. Thank you so much, and hope you have more seasons to come. It's going to be wonderful. Have a great day.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
Take care.